After Jesus Christ was judged of the high priest, taken to Pontius Pilate to be judged, beaten, judged by Herod, and then judged again of Pilate, he was taken in front of his Jewish accusers by Pilate. The most vocal of the group was comprised of the chief priests of the temple and the leaders of the Sanhedrin, the Jewish ruling body. The day was Friday of Holy Week, at about 6 or 7 in the morning. In the scriptures, we read of the profound interchange that took place between Pilate and the Jewish leaders. When Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, he took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, "I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See ye to it." Then answered all the people and said, "His blood be on us and on our children." Here among the group were many of the priests of the temple, including the high priest himself, who well understood the concept of a blood atonement. The word kafar, atone, in Hebrew means to cover, blot out, expiate, condone, or cancel. For the priests, this term also had a literal application during the temple sacrifices, wherein a portion of the blood of the animal was dabbed upon the altar, covering it with the blood of the sacrifice. In addition, on the Day of Atonement, the holiest day of the year, the high priest entered into the Holy of Holies of the temple and dabbed or covered the four corners of the Ark of the Covenant. Because of these rituals, the act of covering with blood and atonement were almost interchangeable for the Israelite people. How ironic that here the people ask that his blood be upon them. Of course, they did not actually request that his blood would atone for them or cover them, but the symbolism of the word they chose still vividly remains. How true their request would be that the blood of the Lamb of God would come upon them or cover them. For Christ did suffer for all, even his accusers. Even more powerful is the statement that his blood be upon their children, for all, both Jew and Gentile, are to be grafted into the lineage of Abraham, thus becoming children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Each of us, in essence, is part of the crowd who requested that Jesus' blood cover them. As sinners, we each have the need of having our sins blotted out or covered up to be remembered no more by God. Truly, it is by his blood coming upon us that we are forgiven. It is through his suffering, death, agony, and resurrection that we will live again. How prophetic the words of these wicked men, who in attempting to place blame on their children, actually helped in providing salvation to their children through the blood of the Lamb of God, the Lamb that on their behalf and by their request was slain.